Hotelling's law, popularly known as the principle of minimum differentiation, was proposed by Harold Hotelling in his thesis Stability in Competition in 1929. Harold Hotelling, 1895 to 1973, was an American statistician and economist affiliated with Stanford University and Columbia University in his early and mid-career years, and then UNC Chapel Hill until his retirement. Aside from the eponymous theory on prices of non-renewable resources, he is known for Hotelling's T-square distribution, Hotelling's law, and Hotelling's lemma. The law refers to the economic observation that competitors in a market economy tend to offer products similar to each other. This is solely because business models generally try to offer products that will captivate most customers. A business that offers a peculiar product that appeals only to a tiny section of population risks losing market share to its competitors who might offer more standardized products. So most businesses end up offering products that appeal to most customers. Consider two political parties choosing their location on the left-right spectrum. Assume the preferences of voters are distributed evenly along this spectrum. If one party chooses an extreme left position, then the other party can secure a majority by locating just to its right. The converse holds for any position except the center. So the only equilibrium has both parties located at the center. Hotelling modeled the way in which firms share the market. He used a simple model in which consumers are evenly dispersed along a line and buy from the nearest firm. The two firms choose to locate at the midpoint of the line. A firm that unilaterally moves away from the midpoint loses market share and profit. At the time Hotelling introduced his model, the prevailing economic thought was that duopoly was fragile, because a small price cut by one firm would capture the entire market. However, this thought was inconsistent with reality, according to Hotelling, because some buy from one seller, some buy from another, in spite of moderate differences of price. The law states that it is a natural tendency for competitors to be pulled towards a common middle ground. Hotelling's law predicts that a street with two shops will also find both shops right next to each other at the same halfway point. Each shop will serve half the market. One will draw customers from the north, the other, all customers from the south. Another example of the law in action is that of two takeaway food pushcarts, one at each end of a beach. If there is an equal distribution of rational consumers along the beach, each pushcart will get half the customers, divided by an invisible line equidistant from the carts. However, each pushcart owner will be tempted to push his cart slightly towards the other, moving the invisible line so that the owner is on the side with more than half the beach. Eventually, the pushcart operators will end up next to each other in the center of the beach. Hotelling originally analyzed the location choice of two competing suppliers of a product and concluded that the equilibrium would have both competitors located next to each other with minimum differentiation. The law has been widely applied to firm location, product selection, and political economy. Harold Hotelling formulated this principle to explain spatial competition. He observed that consumers prefer the nearest of two options when purchasing fixed-priced goods with identical features. This forces both firms to locate in the middle of the market, because a firm that chooses to locate to one side of the middle would leave the larger portion of the market to its competitors. Spatial differentiation, or the lack of it, is a useful metaphor for quality or feature differentiation in products. Consumers choose products from one of two firms with a mix of features that are closest to their ideal mix. Some consumers prefer curly pasta, some prefer whole wheat pasta shells. If consumer preferences vary uniformly across all possible feature combinations, it again pays for both firms to create products that sort of appeal to everybody. If instead one firm chooses a mix of features that appeals especially well to a small segment of consumers, it leaves a larger segment to its competitors. Hotelling's law also explains why retailers and restaurants so often locate near one another. The classic example is ice cream vendors locating near one another on a beach. That is it for today's video. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to our channel, Explified.